Most herbicide labels read, "Do not spray during a temperature inversion." But what is a temperature inversion? We're going to give you a brief overview in this presentation. On a typical day, when there's no inversion present, the sun is shining, it's emitting energy to the earth. The earth's surface is going to heat up, and in turn, it's going to emit radiation to its surroundings, including the air near it. That air is going to then warm from the heat, and it's going to expand and rise. Cooler, more dense air is going to then settle in. It's going to get warmed, and it's going to expand and rise. And you're going to get a constant shuffling of the air. This can usually be observed by wind. So as the cool and warm air mix, you get wind. And cumulus clouds usually sit atop these air mixing columns. When an inversion begins to set in, it's typically close to sunset or shortly after, and the sun is no longer emitting energy to the earth, so the earth is going to begin to cool. If there's no clouds in the sky, so if it's a clear night, any heat left in the earth is in the earth's atmosphere is going to escape into space. There's not going to be cool and warm air mixing, so you're not going to get the wind movement. And what's going to happen is the cooler air is going to be settled near the earth's surface, and the warmer air is going to be above that. When this happens, there's no real reason for the air to mix. Cooler air is more dense than warmer air, and this air mass is very stable, and that's when we have a temperature inversion. And this stable air mass provides a place for herbicide particles to be suspended. So if you spray into it, the particles may remain in that stable air mass. A lot of what we know about temperature inversions is from work on pollution, and you think about smog and how you can see pollution particles in those clouds. It's kind of a similar situation when we think about herbicides being suspended in an inversion. So what are some indicators of a temperature inversion? Clear skies at night is one indicator that an inversion is forming. If you don't have those cumulus clouds, you don't have anything to trap heat in the Earth's atmosphere. Two more indicators are low-lying fog as well as dew and frost. However, these indicators are typically seen in the morning towards the end of an inversion, and don't tell you a lot about the inversion setting in. One that we have been studying further is low wind speeds. So you have that still, stable air mass, not a lot of wind going on. And our research suggests that when you have wind speeds less than 3 miles per hour, it correlates fairly well with when a temperature inversion is occurring. This has just been a brief introduction to temperature inversions. We do have some preliminary data on our website. If you go to the 5th tab down on the left side, it slideshows, and within that page, you can see that Dr. Bradley has posted a slideshow on the summarizing the injury that occurred in Southeast Missouri this year and some of the factors that may have contributed to that off-target movement. And our preliminary data suggests that temperature inversions may have been one of multiple factors that contributed.